If there is a test on Monday, people actually xerox it on Saturday, study it on Sunday, and get it on Monday. That is, next 23 days they don't study that. Right, this is now a trend that we have noticed. But this way what we are doing is actually, it is unlikely that anybody would ignore a message without reading it. So at least the terminologies which are there, what is cloud computing, what is SaaS application, they at least keep hearing to that. Okay. So every day, by doing this actually, we did this about 200 messages we have done, okay? And look at this also. So we force students to read on the terms every day, so that in a month of, in a span of 40 days, we learned that at least people are talking the terminology related to class examination much before examination announced. Okay, so one of the best ways to get people to get the, actually start using it, and we use extensively this cell mechanism, and this is free, again, you can use that, and there are 144 students in our class, and we have posted some 288 messages.
I think I'll show you what kind of a messages we did for.
What we did for 2 years, the small experiment using for the current it was a beginning because we didn't have that much technology and all. But the whole idea is this: today we made a joke in our department. What is that? Is it is possible to download everything from internet today except money. What it actually means is every resource which you think of using is available free. Take for example, I wanted to send SMS free to my student, it is available. I want to share my lessons, the blog for this video. So you think of an idea, you get a resource to support it. It's only a question of thinking. Okay. And world has become so charitable that download has become a most used term today. Okay. That means people are ready to share and resources are available. Okay. All that you have to do is find your application to do that. For example, I have a teacher who keeps moving, so I'm using PPTs of Google. Somebody can be using some mobile devices, right? So that is the whole idea. And today, everything is supports mobile blogging. For example, blogging today, if you want to convert your blogs into the current blog into a kind of a mobile thing, it is available. That means on the go, student can read. On the go, you can post, which will directly go to your blogs. Okay. So what it means is, infrastructure is available, requirement is available, okay. And Google supports all kind of mobile learning, and you can connect, you can click any one of them and see that one. And today in India also, for example, look, IGNU supports this.
Look at this.
IGNU extends mobile learning. So that means is a trend which is accepted by top people and small people like us who identify as class and even anybody in between. Okay. The whole message is to tell us there is a change in trend and there is a tools available. And if you want to think of conveniently educating your children, there are many ways available. And it is better that as a part of this, whatever called digital revolution and all, ask people to text, and every time he texts, actually he goes. And every time he texts, actually he gets connected to an active mind. Like when you read a book now, actually you are connecting to at least not a practically dead mind, because he doesn't talk back to you. Whereas you send a message or talk to Google or something, you are always talking to an active mind. Okay. So now it is time to move, and when you move, it becomes mobile, and there are lot of tools which are available to support that kind of thing. So the whole conclusion, we have numbers, that means number of people who are mobile, that means either computers or Akash or cell phone. And we have resources, that means I told you, most charitable time that we are living, we can get everything. And we have reasons when trend is changing. So for that reason, it is time to much of our learning resources into cloud and into mobile and start doing that kind of thing. In fact, it is possible that if you have a small kid at home and if she or he has cell now, you can tell the entire story of Ramayana by bit, and in a year or 2 years you can complete the entire story. You don't have to sit in pain because time is a thing which is of great demand. Right? So with this I conclude my presentation, and if you are interested in the research aspects of that and how to design a cloud computing based mobile learning, this is an IEEE paper published in ASEA, and the cloud computing through mobile learning, this is also a research paper called the paper. So that means even scholars are working on this. So thank you. And as I told you, my presentation will always be available here. So all my presentations will be available here after you look at this upcoming presentation and all. And if you are interested in how to use online teaching and testing tools in your learning process, you can click on that one. So just yesterday I was in Tamil Nadu, there's a college called MOP. They are conducting a NAC conference on that. I just presented them. So
that is github.blogspot.com,
yes.
Dot in.
Comma also is
working.
So if you have any question in between, you can ask them. You can ask that, or in case you don't find this one, actually you can also ask directly from here. I'll show you. We have put a form here. You can say ask a question, you'll get an answer. We normally answer in 24 hours. So this is actually for our students, but this is actually very long. So,
thank you, sir, for an excellent talk on cloud-based mobile learning. It is really very beneficial for all the faculty members to use cloud services for their educational activities. Thank you very much. Now, may I request Professor Atul Naini to kindly present a memento on behalf of organizers to Dr. Ravindra. Now we'll move on to the next talk, presentation on the topic cloud-based mobile learning by Dr. Ravindra. Dr. Ravindra is currently serving as the Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Harvard, Karnataka, where he began his career way back in 1987. Ravindra Dastikop had earlier education in Belgaum, Mandya and Mysore, and completed his graduation in science and postgraduate diploma in computer applications from SJCC Mysore in 1986. Later, he pursued his engineering degree, post-graduation and further qualifications from BITS Pilani. Currently, his teaching interests are around cloud computing and social media. He offers a semester-long course, Introduction to Cloud Computing, for all branches of engineering. He is planning to offer a Designing Cloud Computing System course for CSE students for upcoming semester. He has taken up many organizational roles, faculty in charge, IPR cell replacement officer. As IPR cell in charge, he conducted two workshops for the management and decision makers in technical education. He was also part of the team that designed IPR curriculum under autonomous scheme. During 2004, he visited Tribhuvan University, Kathmandu, Nepal as a visiting faculty and taught a course in programming languages. In that same year, he was invited to be an adjunct faculty at International Institute of Information Technology, Bangalore. During 2004, he spent a sabbatical at Infosys, Bangalore, where he studied the knowledge management system for 8 weeks. And have attended many conferences, taken up different roles, paper presented, chairing a session, reviewing the paper and more. Some of the major conferences that he was actively involved involves IEEE Technology for Education, that is the T4E conference, ACM SAGAR 2008 and ESSIR 2007 and more. So may request Dr. Ravindra to kindly deliver talk on cloud-based mobile learning.
Good afternoon, everybody. And see, today's topic is actually mobile and ubiquitous computing. And mobility is something which animals have, unlike plants, because plants are always stationary. And today's technology has added many dimensions to our mobility. And probably, if you see any presenter who is coming to make a presentation, either you will bring your laptop and start his presentation, take 10 minutes to adjust, and or bring his pen drive and sit there and find it all difficult. But today the technology supports your mobility to that extent that you don't have to depend on any machine. For example, when I came here, all that I did was I just checked whether the internet connectivity or not, and I went into my blog, which is mobile. Okay. But now I go to my presentation, which is here, and start my presentation. So this kind of a technology which comes wherever you go or wherever you prepare is something like your Hutch dog. Where actually it's called network, right? See, the dog follows wherever you, but cloud computing still goes further beyond that. The problem with HutchDog is it will ask you roaming charges if you cross the country in Bangladesh, right? Whereas cloud computing doesn't do that. Because I prepared this presentation way back in my Dharwad, and actually I was in Chennai. So there also made this presentation, here also made. So the mobile computing, mobile learning is all about this, using such resources for supporting your learning and teaching. And in this case, actually, I'm using a presentation for Google, okay? So which supports what is known as presentation like PPT. Second is about ubiquitous. That also will tell you what it is. So my presentation will talk about cloud-based mobile learning experience in real-world teaching. So sometime back, we used this mobile to partly teach our course in an engineering college. Okay, we'll tell you how we used SMS and how actually what we did. And that was our beginning. And we also talk about resources which are available. In case if you want to become a mobile learner or a mobile teacher, what are the resources available? And what are the reasons for doing this? The simple reason is actually everybody is becoming mobile and travel time becomes your study time. Right? So that means the best time and the longest time that you sit any one location is when you are traveling, not when you are in office and all. Okay. So that is the reason, second reason. And thirdly, our experiment that we have done, and finally, the results that we have obtained. So in this presentation, I'm sharing my experience of discovering and deploying mobile resources. Mobile resources means you are not stuck to a location. You cannot say that I cannot get my printout because it is in my machine, in my server, in my college. If you say that I can get that presentation as long as there's the internet, then you are mobile. Okay. So that kind of a thing. Okay. So new media, new education, and new opportunity. So mobile has become a new medium. Because of that, there's a new opportunity that I'll be talking. And also talking about the power and potential. What is the actual power of mobile? And finally, the one. And we also instill. That means when we say some theory, we also tell you that this is what the experiment we have done. So before understanding learning, we have to understand the basics of education. You know, the education has only two basics. One is actually make people knowledgeable. That means if he's ignorant, then you have to teach him certain things saying that this is not true and this is actually good. For example, if you get lung diseases and all, it is not because of your karma you are getting, because there are viruses. That's the reason it becomes. Okay? So this kind of education in which you liberate the person from the local thinking to a broader thinking called liberal education. So that is exactly what happened between 14th century and 18th century when people established universities because book came into being and people can write good information and everybody could share. Okay. So that happened until 18th century. That's the reason even after 19th century because India did not have any good engineer because everybody was liberal education. Whether it's Ambedkar or it's Gandhi, they studied law and studied arts, studied history. Right? But now after 1950 when we started the technological thing, then we had to have this technical education. Technical education is what? Is the ability to contribute. There is a machine, you must build it. There is a machine that you have to repair. There is a system that you have to develop, for example, an electrical system, or a damming system, or a transportation system. So there are two kinds of education. One is liberal education, where actually you overcome your ignorance. Technical education, where you get an ability to do certain things, like writing a program, or design a team. Okay. But the scope and ability of your education depends on the media that you have. What it actually means is, suppose you have an old media where you cannot study law. You can have now that we have Digisat, because there is INSAT. INSAT is the telecom operator. Similarly, since we have IGNU, we have actually TV. So that means there is something called Dhyanavahini from IGNU, which can educate everybody, for example, morning and dark. That is because we have a new tool called TV. Right? Okay. So the whole point is to say is actually, education and its ability depends on what you have, and our ability to transmit whatever the knowledge which was there is depending on the media that you have. Before 14th century, there was only one way of teaching people, that is oral education, because there was no book. So that means whatever you learn depends on the vivid fancy of your teacher, and whatever you learn depends by the amount of memory that you have. You cannot learn more because you can't recall more. Okay. So now, media is education. For that reason actually, media means education, education means media. Because in the absence of textbook now, you cannot consider university education because university education is built on books. Right? So historically if you look at this, this is how it started. When there was no books, it was oral education. When it was manuscript and printed book, it was printed education. Everything is printed, like how many articles you have published in general, how many books you have written. So every measure is against what you write and what you read.
Okay.
Then when you have electronic education, then the question is not book, it is CDs. Okay. How many CDs you have, what is the self-learning, e-learning and all. So that means it's always a function of what is media that you have and what education that you can deliver. Today, historically, the impact of new technology always has changed the direction of education. For example, e-learning is possible because we have disks. Okay. Today, it is possible to have a Dhyanavahini from IGNU because we have television. So, television is a new media which is used for education. Okay. So, similarly, today, mobile is a new media. Media is what it actually carries some content and it carries your connection. Book is what actually if you carry some content and it is available that you can read that. Okay. So whenever there is a new media, there is a new kind of education that will happen. So now that I have told you that mobile is a new media, then I will tell you what are the resources available which will support this kind of a media. See, look at this. Cloud computing is a new media. And when I put this presentation, cloud computing is a dash opportunity. I know 9 out of 10 people in the audience will not know that word. And 10 out of 10 people will not know its pronunciation. And that is intentional. What to just be able to say that, now that I don't know the meaning of this word, can I get this meaning? So the cloud computing says yes. Somebody has outed a dictionary somewhere on the earth, I mean on the planet, and you can get that dictionary meaning here. This is the beauty of cloud computing. That means it will move education wherever you are. Currently, I'm actually accessing from this. I can get it from cell. I can get it from your desktop, wherever you go. That means you don't have to buy a dictionary. Now go to library. Okay. So this is what is mobility is all about. Mobility is what? I will take you to wherever you want to go. Similarly, I will push everything that you need to wherever you want. You can be eating your breakfast, still get the meaning of this without getting muddy when you can. Right? So that is what is all about education itself. So there are resources. The first resource is cloud computing. That means it can deliver you the resources. In this actually it was generating dictionary. But it is possible that you get the entire encyclopedia. It is possible that you get the entire other programming code and all. So this is the first probability factor. See, now that cloud computing can deliver all these things. For example, now you can get a database, encyclopedia, and you can get an application server like Google, or you can get code. Our engineering student knows how to download a Java code, that kind of thing. Okay, and that can be delivered to any one of these things, PC, mobile, and cell. Okay, cell is an American word for pager. So what it actually means, as long as it can happen on the internet, it can be delivered to anything. And today what people are thinking at a different level is actually, there are three screens in this world. What is your cell screen, computer screen, and TV screen? And there is no person in the world who is not looking at any one of them. Okay. Now, cloud computing, what it does actually, it can move the content to any one of this. That means we can educate anybody. And today, India has 70 crore cells. That means even if there is no electricity, in that place there is a cell. Okay. So the earlier arguments that you cannot go to rural places and educate people, it is not needed now actually, because cells can take that role and start at least some basic education, for example, to teach alphabet, cell is okay. Okay, so that kind of a thing is possible. Secondly, there is something called social cloud. That means everybody started participating. For example, if I ask a question like how many people are there on Facebook, probably everybody would raise their hand. Okay, so intentionally actually you have come to Facebook. Now Facebook is actually a kind of a social media which can be connected with mobile. Okay, and see, there is a problem of building schools and getting students there. Okay, so building school is one difficulty, and after building school, getting students is difficult. So that means it's like, see, taking Muhammad to mountain. What it means is possible. But today, if you want to go to social media and teach people, now people are already there and you already started learning. Okay, so it is better instead of asking people to come to classroom, if you can move your education to social media like Facebook and all, they will start learning. What it actually means is moving the mountain to Muhammad, because Muhammad is not coming to mountain. So then we also have a mobile cloud. What we mean by mobile cloud is actually, if you look at the picture now, everywhere is actually connected with mobile. So that means the meeting that you wanted now, actually I was getting on this machine, but it is also possible to develop itself. So that means if you want to learn, no matter where you are, not necessarily in educational setting or otherwise, you can start learning. So mobility is another meaning of mobility, is that it can start on cloud and with your mobile. Okay. Thirdly, we have this, the data. So data would actually mean first content. So you can write a book, write a lesson, write an instruction, write a question, and put it on cloud. For example, the whole thing which is I am showing you is written because there is some cloud storage called Google Data, where actually I have uploaded my presentation. I am not carrying my pen drive. So that means this can be converted into an instructional material and give it to anybody. So for example, now I am doing a presentation on PPT. But this could be a presentation which I do with my teaching, and everybody can access that. So that means data is needed to write a material, it's available. You need a means to reach some people, that's available. Okay. And there is when people are willingly coming to that media, people may not come to library, because its last 2 years I have not gone to library. Okay. And people don't read much, because my children don't read newspaper, so I get to newspaper every day. That is what is actually happening. Now that is how we should take. So because of there are certain events which are happening, we have different trends which are happening in the world. And we should look at the trends, because if you ignore trends, you will miss the path. So ubiquity is one meaning. What it actually means, you will find everywhere an intelligent device available. If I ask here, probably everybody is carrying a cell. And all cells are intelligent devices. In addition to that, we have this. In addition to that, we have internet. So if you take any 1 by 1 or 10 by 10 square feet area, you will find at least 3 or 4 devices. One way or the other connected. And probably if you have been traveling all the time, you look at the moment you go to railway station, you get a message. Railway is trying to put a SMS to you, or can I get this as a Bluetooth message? Okay. The moment you go to airport, you will get. That means people are trying to use Bluetooth and all to get connected to you. That is a fact that Bluetooth is available there, means multiple devices are available. In a place called railway station where you don't know people much. Okay. So that is what is actually called ubiquity computing. That means if I have something on cloud, I can deliver it anywhere. For simple reason, everybody is carrying one or the other device. Second one is actually apps. So today, cell has become a kind of a necessity. Because even to tell my kid, not I'm getting 5 minutes late or 50 minutes late now, cell is the best device. Right? Instead of selling any other device. And because of that, and almost all these cells actually have different kind of applications. There are applications, for example, now for most people use only games and all other applications, but there are learning applications which are available. Similarly, databases are available. For example, dictionary you can get, encyclopedia you can get. And and storage, in case you want to produce some content as a part of an assignment and all, that can also be uploaded to yourself to many people. For example, today, normally I upload one or two photos through my Facebook myself, and today there are 250 million photos uploaded every day through yourself. A complicated thing like photo can be uploaded. What it means is, if you have a neat diagram which is connected to your teaching, you can upload it immediately and share with your student. That means whatever that is needed for us is already available. Because of this, look at the center, there is a cell, and through using that cell, actually, you can connect it to anything, like from a live streaming, like getting YouTube and kind of a thing, or actually some kind of electronic application, for example, like currency conversion or databases and all. So that means if you have a cell, you are connected to the world. And if cell is there, that means you are ubiquitously connected to everybody. For example, and without your intention, various wireless will try to connect you before the moment you go to the station. So that means people are willing to connect to people who already have some devices. That means an educator can get connected to a student, or an university can get connected to a learning community, and so on and so forth. So this is what ubiquitous learning. Because of this, actually, mobile has become your new slate. Now people don't write, people text. Right? So people like us, we went to school with that slate and wrote for 8 to 10 years. And at the end of 10th year, all that we had is a good handwriting. Right? Today, handwriting is not needed. For a simple reason that you go to railway station, there is an online form. If you write a CET examination, there is an online form. Okay. So it is not correct for us to ask people, when students, to learn handwriting, because handwriting nobody will read. Secondly, even in jobs like assignment and all, what actually happens is one will produce 59 copies with an assurance that teachers don't read their assignments. Right? So now texting seems to be replacing your writing. And whenever somebody texts, now texting becomes a skill. That's exactly what happens on the internet today. Look at the right side, it's actually any application like Google or Facebook and all. So what happens, you edit a message and publish it, somebody will comment it. And today, one more thing what's happening, like unlike the olden days of Newton and all, one person will not have all the knowledge. We all have a fragmented knowledge. What it means is, I know best routes for Madras, somebody else will know another two routes, which are different. So if I post a message, like see when I come to Hyderabad, normally I post a message, like I am going to Hyderabad, what's the best way? One of my students will post a message, like last week I went by this, going by this. Recently somebody told him, sir, you don't take this route to Mantralaya because there is a bridge construction and there is a problem. Okay. So this, now by texting that, you are asking a question and you are getting an answer. So if you write it on your paper and circulator, you don't get it. Okay, so because of this, mobile has become your platform and texting has become a skill. Okay, so for that reason, web or cloud has become a new learning habitat. What it means is, learning now doesn't happen in classroom. Reading doesn't happen in library. And this is true for every traditional thing. More people will watch cricket match outside stadium than in stadium. Right? More people will watch movies outside film theaters than in theaters. For the same reason, more people will learn something more outside classroom than in class. So asking people to come to classroom is something working against the trend. Right. So this is a fact. See, because I have kids and I have also been acting with kids. So I know this. Okay. So for that reason, today web has become a kind of a cloud means web, web means mobile. That's because, for example, now actually for me, cloud has been mobile, cloud actually has become a kind of a classroom today. So that means my presentation on this particular subject is always available. Normally whenever a teacher goes to a classroom with a PPT, the first reaction from the student is that this guy must have downloaded from the net. Okay. And I'm not interested in this. So he will go off mood and at the end of the class he will come with his pen drive. Sir, give me a copy of this. So that is true. And giving to 60 students is a big headache. Because, and we are scared about their pen drive usages, so we don't know where they are used. So now actually by doing this kind of thing, actually what we have done is, anybody can download this, just click here. You can download it from here. You can download it to this presentation. So that means this presentation is available not only during 1 hour of my class, it is 24/7, wherever he is there. So that means he can learn from it. So this kind of mobility is also there available today.
You have
So the whole idea is to say that there is a change in the trends and there is a change in the resources that is available for us, and this is a tactical mobile in everything that we do, including teaching. Now I will tell you, I will show you. So that means everything that you want to do can be done on cloud, and when you do that, you don't restrict students to coming to a classroom and studying it, which even if they come, they don't do that. Okay. So that is the whole idea. And by doing this, actually, you can also help students. For example, if for some reason, see, normally you probably have noticed that if there's a cultural event in any college, 25 people who are culturally interested will stay. 75 people, they will go to home. They don't stay in the campus only. So if for whatever reason they are not staying in a capital and all, actually you can support their education. And all this can be converted and sent to their mobile also, all this. So what are the benefits from this? Okay. So you can add any number of devices. I'll show you an experiment where actually we have done that. Means we have managed 144 students using that. Okay. And secondly, from a student perspective, I told you, today traveling is a fringe benefit for everybody in metros. Okay, even they say, not companies will give you 2 hours of traveling every day. Right? Now, today for the first time, traveling time is actually your study time. Traveling time is the one time in which you are not disturbed by anyone. Okay, so instead of waiting for your desk time, going to a study room or a library, you start using your thing. Okay, and if you do that, then probably that becomes the best time, and your mobile learning will support that kind of a thing. For example, you can say that I will read only one lesson during my presentation today. And secondly, actually, you can start a course on your home. That means you can start a new chapter there, and whatever that you complete there, and you, the rest of the part can be completed in your travel, and you, by the end you reach your office, actually you have completed one chapter. This is possible because it is possible to release contents in a small format to yourself as a message, and you can keep learning. For example, it's like pointed answers or pointed lessons of a particular course. I'm sure you have to do that. So, we did a small experiment last year. So there are many free SMS services in India, right? So what we did actually is we used one of those services in this. So we used to send 4 messages every day. That means if my class, cloud computing class at 8 o'clock, I will be starting this chapter today. So a message will go because there is a restriction of 140 characters. So halfway through the class, we used to tell again, this is the summary and is there any question on this. Okay. So there will be 4 messages which is going to a student every day on that particular chapter. And this will actually support one more thing in education. Normally